Hello! Did you hear the news? DALL-E 2 has a secret language. If one lets DALL-E 2 generate an image from Apoplo ves realitais, it will generate birds. Contara cet kniams lurica tanionons generates bugs or pests. Miss Coffee Bean, are you drunk? In this video, we will discuss what the discoverers of this phenomenon have told us on Twitter and in their archive paper about this. We will see what theories the community has come up with to explain how DALL-E 2 can generate sensible output from gibberish. And we will realize that we should guard ourselves from the incoming flood of clickbait titles, because spoilers, but no, DALL-E 2 does not have an own language. Language or not, DALL-E 2's gibberish is an interesting phenomenon to look at nonetheless, so let's discuss this in this AI coffee break. But before we dive in, let's thank Weights & Biases for supporting us in this video. Today we are discussing DALL-E 2 from OpenAI that generates images from text, only that the code and weights for this model are not released. But DALL-E Mini and DALL-E Mega are open source projects by Boris Daima that replicate OpenAI's efforts, and the cool thing is that Boris used Weights & Biases reports to track and communicate his progress. Of course, because Weights & Biases reports are incredibly flexible, allowing to communicate your work to colleagues, managers, or even just yourself. In this report, Boris is keeping a training journal of how his latest model training is going, which he updates regularly with notes about new experiments and changes to the model's training regime that he's trying. Reports are a great tool for education and sharing analysis for your colleagues or the wider world. The report here is more polished than the previous one and contains educational graphics as well as interactive Weights & Biases charts and tables to help the reader understand the results of his work. Finally, for those of us with not enough time, reports are a perfect way to create a concise, real-time and high-level dashboard for a more focused summary of how a project or model is doing. Go to 1db.me/ai-coffee-break to explore and interact with these reports yourself and see how reports can help you share your work with colleagues around the world. Okay, so here's the news. We have this text-to-image generation model DALL-E 2 from OpenAI. It's a diffusion model that can take in text and produce an amazing picture. If you're interested in how text-to-image diffusion models work, check out our previous videos on this. But now, here's the catch. DALL-E 2 can not only take in sensible input text and produce its best shots at an image from this, but no, it can take in gibberish and produce output that looks really good. And even more, it seems like this gibberish does mean something for the model, because the combination of something that produces birds with something that produces bugs in Apoplo ves realitais eating contara cet kniams lurica tanionuns gives images of birds eating bugs. Is this language? No, it's not, as the authors have quickly realized after announcing their findings on Twitter and changed their paper title from secret language to secret vocabulary. Language has syntax and grammar, but DALL-E 2 seems rather to respond at gibberish words. So how did the authors find and generate such examples? It seems like the discovery happened while the authors were playing with the text rendering capabilities of DALL-E 2. The model is already known to produce very weird results on this, so they gave the model an input where it had to produce text, like two farmers talking about vegetables with subtitles, and found that the produced text is not as random as one might think. This word, vicutes, produces dishes with vegetables, and apoplo ves realitars produces birds. So the authors concluded that the farmers must be talking about birds messing with their vegetables. In this thread, you can see other examples too, but what we see there and in the paper are not really many examples, and it is a bit unclear on what the success rate of this method is. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, as highlighted in this thread, where only 4 out of 10 examples generate sports from the word tibur, even though, like in the farmer's examples, those two men speak about tibur, which seems to be about sports. So why does this even happen that Dali 2 generates good-looking pictures from gibberish? The authors make the fuzzy claim that the model has internally developed a hidden language, we mean vocabulary, after being trained on image-text pairs. Well, this is not very specific, so let's look at the theories circulating on Twitter right now, because there are a few very interesting ones. The first one I saw was by Joscha Bach. He points out that the text generations are quite inconsistent. In the paper, the authors prompt Dali 2 with two whales talking about food with subtitles, but Joscha Bach points out that the secret words one gets from this are different every time. So Joscha Bach goes on saying that the secret words are just random strings that sometimes point to consistent regions in the embedding space. The model projects the samples into high-dimensional space and clusters neighboring concepts. Then honestly, I do not get what the rest of the explanation wants to say. Maybe you know, so go to the comments and explain it if you want. So here is Miss Coffee Bean's take on this, which might be very different from the one in this thread. Sorry. The model has a limited number of parameters, and for efficiency reasons, it needs to cluster the space of words well. So concepts that are related to one another should be close in this space. Since we are working with neural networks, the text is represented as continuous vectors, but surprise, text is discrete and is composed of words that do not have an in-between as continuous vectors do, and since the model always must produce an output, whatever the input, the in-between words, so gibberish, will also produce an output. As it turns out, this is sometimes consistent between the string input and rendered text in the image. How seldomly this works and how inconsistent this is highlighted by another Twitter user who points out that the bug-producing prompt does not produce so many bugs or pests after all, since in these Dali 2 generations we also have animals like deer and goats. Still along the line of the discreteness of language are the opinions that say that the secret language is most due to tokenizer effects, since Apodidae and Ploceidae are families of birds, each with more than 100 species. Apodiformes is the biggest order of birds with 400 and more species of birds. So the model has connected the Apo and Plo subwords to birds. Somebody else found that one can infer some of these subwords that will work with Dali 2 by looking at Wikipedia, where Actinopterygii and Placodermi are two families of fish, and then Placoactinknunfidg generates fish images. You know, with neural networks, sometimes it is great input in, garbage out. Now it's gibberish in, quality images out, and everybody freaks out. It's clear that we do not yet understand these black boxes, and unless some more rigorous interpretability goes into these models, we will continue prompting in the dark, and we will hope for the best. It's important to highlight that as long as we are surprised by this weird way of communication from Dali 2 and similar models, we are also ignorant of some security issues. Adversarial attacks with these gibberish prompts, as well as not-so-gibberish prompts, can trigger unwanted behavior from models, circumventing filters on the allowed inputs. It's clear that so far these models do not behave like humans would expect them to, and malicious humans could take advantage of this. What do you think about this? Would you be interested to enroll in Miss Coffee Bean's Dali 2 language classes? See you next time.